Experience, Somi and Daymé Arocena. Supported by a 60-piece all-black orchestra, the Vuyani Dance Theatre, and so much more. Come enjoy the Simphiwe Dana Symphony Experience 2019. 7 December at the South African State Theatre in Pretoria. Tickets now selling for 500 rand via web tickets. The Simphiwe Dana Symphony Experience 2019. In partnership with the Department of Arts and Culture, VET Africa and Kaya FM.
And of course, just listening to that, you kind of feel like, you know, you want to be there, you want to go and, of course, experience that. And imagine a singer, songwriter and activist, Simphiwe Dana, alongside US-based Rwandan artist Somi, plus the dynamic and resonant young voice of Daymé Arocena from Cuba, all on one stage. Well, you can experience that, and all of this happening on the 7th of December at the South African State Theatre in Tshwane during the Simphiwe Dana Symphony Experience. And Simphiwe Dana is here to speak to me about that. Welcome.
Hi, Sakina. Thank you so much for having me.
So this is, of course, the second installment, the first happening in 2016.
Yes.
Talk to us about what inspired this.
Well, I wanted to be that person who practices what they preach. So I'm a Pan-African and I'm always canvassing for African unity, cohesion, Pan-Africanism. And I felt that us as Africans, we are very much ostracized from each other for various reasons. And that for us to move forward as a unit so we can do business with each other, we can create situations where, you know, things circulate amongst us as Africans, whether it be businesses, whether it be culture, whether it be anything for that matter, we need to find avenues for cohesion. And therefore, I created the Symphony Experience that focuses on African women, black women, and showcases black excellence.
And what was the response like to the first edition?
The first one was really amazing. It was very challenging to put it together, I must say. But people on stage didn't see any of that. It was truly, truly amazing. I remember Buika even saying after that, Simphiwe, I saw you and how you put all of this together, how you worked with everyone and kept everyone calm, even during like the very hectic times. I think you're a maestra. And for me, that was the highest compliment I got for that symphony.
And that was, of course, Buika from Equatorial Guinea.
Yes.
And you had Asha from Nigeria.
Yes.
As well. So how do you go about selecting the artist that you want to share this experience with?
Well, I actually find people like me, artists like me who have the same temperament, who also even their ideals are aligned with mine. That's how I find them, and also whose music is more roots music. I like that because it basically focuses on us, on who we are and what makes this continent tick.
So the two artists who will be joining you this time around, what exactly about them is it that resonates with you?
Well, Somi is from Rwanda, based in the US, and I've seen her over the years, how she's been trying to reconnect with the continent, even though she's based in the US. And even now, she's doing a play based on Mira Makeba. And even when I first met her, she was performing with Huma Sikela in New York. That's how I was introduced to her. And even her music, she's got an album called the Lagos Music Salon. And in fact, I actually thought she was Nigerian when I first, because of that album. And then I got to realize, well, no, she's from Rwanda, but she tries to connect with the continent, and I truly appreciate that. Now, Daymé is an Afro-Cuban who perhaps constructs her music like I do mine, because she's very much voice-based, like harmonies-based, lots of a cappella-like sounds in her music. And she's young, and she does big bands like I do. And I felt I need to get to know her more. So I have not met her personally. Same way last time I knew Asha, but I never met Buika personally, but I loved her her constitution as an artist. Same thing with Daymé. So I look forward to meeting with her. She's arriving today.
And of course, ultimately, what's the objective? And especially given where we are in contemporary South Africa, where the rest of the continent may not look upon us as favorably as we would like them to, given some of the experiences that some of our brothers and sisters have had here in South Africa.
I hear you when it comes to that. So my main prerogative when it comes to this is to create a safe space where we can all interact as Africans, and music is a very powerful tool for that, where we can even explore each other culturally in safe spaces. And therefore, perhaps when we can see the synergies, when we can see the similarities, and when we can celebrate the diversity as well, perhaps we'll be one step closer. I do believe that music is the most powerful tool to create unity.
And of course, this has been proven over and over again. And thank you so much to singer, songwriter, and activist Simphiwe Dana, speaking to us about the upcoming Simphiwe Dana Symphony Experience. And that's taking place on the 7th of December at the South African State Theatre in Tshwane. And it will feature US-based Rwandan artist Somi and the dynamic and resonant young voice, as she had explained, of Daymé. So looking forward to all of that. And with that, I guess we just have a few moments left to be saying our goodbyes.